This is the presentation as before. We are requesting the court to sign over the matter so we can consult with our clients. Yes, Yoship, the learner stated that it came to me that there was a challenge with the small mention of the law in the charge sheet. Just the secretary has corrected that. And that page, I missed that. That's
the title. The state indicated that there was?
There's a need to an amendment on the section. I think that's what that is. Two small amendments by coming.
Yoship, just two small things. One, on page two, under count one and two, the name of 837 was not included.
Page two
of the church, the amended church sheet.
Yes.
Under count page, count one, count two, which has all their names. And lastly, count seven, which has all their names, but the name of A37, Umar, the last at least person so far. His name was omitted. We realized and wish to substitute those pages, just the name. And then also on the same count, seven, the law was wrong reported.
Wait, let's ask what's known.
Okay.
You are beginning from page two.
Yeah, page two, under count one. My lord, it's not page two. It should be where there is count one. I don't think that should be not page.
Page three,
but specifically page four.
You see, it's not numbered them, but
yeah, it's not numbered.
It's count one.
Yeah, count one.
Who is?
Yeah, where all their names are indicated.
Yes.
Yeah, we realize that the name of A37, Umar, it stops at the name of Honorable Zaki Francis.
Yes.
But should also have A37, Umar.
Oh.
Yeah, it was an omission. Just page 5. Page 5. Okay. Page 5. Actually, on the same page 5, also an account 2, the same omission. We typed an amendment, just the name. We have a typed copy.
Oh, you have a typed copy?
Yeah. Just substitute
what you
call the. And then even the last page of the. You can remove and have the
steps.
Just remove. So the change is just in respect to count one, two, and count seven, where the name of A37 was written. And then also the second change is in respect to the same count seven, the law was wrongly cited. It's supposed to be the Traffic and Road Safety Act, CAP 361, not 1988. There's no such a law.
It's
CAP 361. CAP 361.
Not
1988. It was a typing error. That's all, George.
Yes.
Yourship, we are consulting with our clients, with our colleagues, and we have the opinion that the communal proceedings continue, so that all these matters be dealt with the High Court in terms of, because we're saying that since these charges arise from the same facts, the High Court can deal with the matter in terms of three and all that at once to avoid embarrassment in the courts. So we have the humble opinion that the proceedings continue, they be committed to the High Court. But once that is done, then Council Attorney will have the right to rejoin in respect of the question reference, because at that point the court didn't give you the right to rejoin. So maybe we'll start with the rejoinder, and then the committee of proceedings will continue.
Mr. Your Honor, I still refer you to the proceedings that are part of the side of March, wherein we raised, 14th day of March, we raised in various, but in simple terms, for our submissions, the rights of all these accused persons protected under Article 28. That's the right to fair hearing, which is made non-derogable under Article 44 of the violation. Throughout the process of arrests, that is the essence of our submissions on that day. And it was our prayer that raises a constitutional question. In rejoinder to my land friend's submission, the same reference is provided for under Article 137, Clause 5 of the 1995 Constitution. Under Article 137, Clause 5. And under Paragraph B of that Clause 5. It provides that once question of interpretation of the Constitution is raised, the court, which in the instant case is this honorable court, shall refer the matter to the Constitution.
Can I also advise you that you reiterate your annual prayers?
Yes, no, because you now reiterate. I only had to bring in the articles of the Constitution under which.
Fine.
References.
You have cited the law, but you reiterate your earlier prayers.
We reiterate our earlier prayers that this honorable court be pleased to refer this entire proceedings to the Constitutional Court.
I want to remember the first comment that this policy has an interment of. Offenses triable by this court and offenses triable by the High Court. Where would have required that this person be in custody of the offenses triable by this court, it would have been appropriate. However, because there are offenses triable by the High Court, there's no reason why we should waste our time here entertaining matters which are not going to be, you know, concluded here, yet there are other matters. So I am not going to allow that this person take plea in either case. I would advise that we go on with the committee of proceedings and leave everything behind. Can we therefore proceed with the committee of proceedings?
Wish to tender an amended indictment so that it is read to the accused persons.
Shall be extended.
until the High Court shall make appropriate orders as it shall be fit. For now, this case file shall be forwarded to the Deputy Regents of Gulu High Court for further management. As far as this case is concerned, before this court issue.
Before court takes leave of the matter, last time we had committed the 27 in respect to only two counts. Today we have seven, my lord, your worship.
I beg your pardon. All the accused persons are hereby committed.
Correct.
All the, all the accused persons are hereby committed. Only seven counts, including those ones which did not take a plea, but they would have taken plea before this court. So all of you shall wait for orders from the Deputy Regents of Gulu High Court. I don't know when she will make her order, probably calling you for trial or something like that. But you will, all of you, extends until when you will be advised otherwise.
Your worship, again, the High Court had made a ruling when they were granted bail that they should report to this court, which has now changed. After committal, which has been done, they were ordered to be reporting to the Deputy Registrar every month. That was the ruling of the High Court.
And indeed, I am referring them to the Deputy Registrar High Court.
So maybe you set the
time frame.
The time frame, yes. Because
you
need
want
to know.
Be specific about the time?
Yes. Because the High Court had already pronounced itself on the 1 month. Yeah. And then also we are praying for warrant of arrest for.
Let me put you on record.
For A22, who is not in court.
You see, we don't have, Mr. Mayor,
yes, Your Worship.
This court doesn't have records from the High Court
to
show that was the direct.
Yeah, but we were all in court, including the accused person. That was the one.
Order, please.
Your Honor, with all due respect, sir, this court has amply concluded the processes for committing the accused persons to the High Court. And I want to quote what you said, that this file will now be referred to the Deputy Registrar for management. Anything beyond that becomes fantasy.
The issue is when?
If there is a ruling, it's written on record. We are bound by rulings of court.
Let me put Mr. Amir on record and then also make a pronouncement on that. Yes, Mr. Amir, you are saying that the High Court has...
Yes, Your Worship, when the accused persons, all of them, at the various times they appeared in court, when they were granted bail by the arrested judge, he ordered that they should be reporting to this court every month until when they are committed to High Court, and then they will continue reporting before the Deputy Registrar. Before the Deputy Registrar. I thought this is what I don't enjoy it. We should be in court.
Finance.
They should report to the Deputy Registrar within the same time frame, so the 1 month. Your Worship, it's unfortunate this Honorable Court may not be having the bail application file from the High Court, but that was the ruling of the High Court. So now that they are committed to High Court, we pray that the same time frame be maintained. If there's any change, they can always put the application before the Deputy Registrar. because there must be a time frame within which the report can't just be left.
Yes.
And secondly, Your Worship, it's on record A22. It's not in court for the second time. None of these sureties has reported to court as to why he is absent. In the circumstance, we pray that the warrant of arrest be issued against him and the two sureties. We shall ensure that he's brought to court. So we pray, Your Worship.
We are praying to reply to this submission as the defense team. Because, again, I want to refer to the ruling of this court that all the accused persons in court and the one who was absent is committed in his absence. And by that alone, this honorable court has washed its hands and handed over the management of this court to the deputy magistrate of the High Court of Gulu. Accordingly, anything done beyond that pronouncement is found as official. So we are praying that this honorable court stands by its earlier, which is sufficient. This case file be managed by the deputy magistrate. If there is any such orders of the High Court, then it's on record. We are officers of court. We are bound by it. No need to overemphasize. Mr.
Thank you.
this is my ruling. This court has made a pronouncement on the subsequent management of this matter on the court record before it. Fortunately, the state has noted that the High Court bail application file is not before this court, and any orders arising therein will be speculative. Therefore, I shall maintain my earlier ruling that the case shall be forwarded to Deputy Register Gulu High Court for appropriate and other orders, as the Deputy Registrar shall be fit. As for A22 Gamba Tunsime, given that he is represented by counsel, I shall give him a benefit of doubt and extend his criminal summons. So, the High Court shall determine on any subsequent orders in as far as this case is concerned. But for me, as far as this case is concerned, it ends today. It is so ordered. That man is there, he can come and report himself.
Yeah.
The deputy register.
Yeah.
The Gamba, even if it's tomorrow or any other day. So I am silent about giving dates.
Yeah.
So the High Court will really give directive as far as this case is concerned.
I don't see what happens.
system.
Bad man, don't apologize to no oppressor. If you teach Rasta man, you will go down your head. We not apologize to no oppressor. Yeah.
Speak up.
Hello?
Yes. Yes.
Thank you.
Where's our
man? How are you? I'm good, but I know you're not fine.
Lucy,